बहादुर एंड ओपी टंडन, ओपी टंडन और पी बहादुर। I'm only talking about chemistry books. Then Cengage is also good. But this is my take on it. MTG questions are good for practice. Our material is also decent. If you follow our material also, but you read NCERT line by line, that will help you most. Okay, my dear friends, see, if you look at any species, suppose you look at CR2O7. Okay, this is a species. A species is anything which has existence. Okay, so CR2O7 2 minus has existence. Whether it is independent existence or with K2, I'm not talking about what kind of existence. I'm saying it has existence. Yeah, so now here there are certain atoms. There is chromium. And there is oxygen. Okay. And they are bonded together. Yeah. Now, you know that an element reacts with another element to complete its octet. Yeah. Now, this completion of octet can happen in two ways. It can happen, one, by exchanging electrons. Okay. I'll say transfer of electrons. Okay, and the second one is by sharing of electrons. Yeah, transfer of electrons and sharing of electrons. Now, we don't care whether it is transfer or sharing, but there are some species, some elements like chlorine, oxygen, nitrogen, which even though they share, they pull the shared pair towards itself. They pull the shared pair towards itself. So, what do you mean by pulling the shared pair towards itself? So, for example, hydrogen shares one electron with chlorine, but this fellow pulls that electron. So, when it pulls that electron, even though this is a covalent bond, it has a charge -1, and hydrogen has a charge +1. This is not a real situation. Yeah, this is not a real situation. But by assuming this, I can answer a lot of questions. Okay. Yeah. So this apparent charge, this is not a real charge because this is not the reality. This apparent charge on any element is called its oxidation number or oxidation state. Okay. For us, both oxidation number and oxidation state are the same. Okay, in certain cases, they are different. We are not talking about it, so let us not talk about it. Now, when we talk about those cases, then we will talk about the difference between oxidation number and oxidation state. As of now, in 8th standard, speed and velocity were the same. But in 11th standard, velocity became a vector, speed is a scalar, and we know how to differentiate it. Right? So, that is the same way we are doing. So, right now, oxidation number and oxidation state are the same. It is the apparent charge which is there on any species. Yeah, It is the apparent charge which is there on any species. So now the question is, how do you calculate it? So this is the way you calculate it. See, you have to read something. You have to make some notes. You have to memorize. It is not that God gave all this knowledge to each one. There is no point saying, I can't understand, I can't understand. This is very simple calculation. One, oxygen is having a charge of -2 always, except in peroxide. Peroxide is O2 2-. In peroxide, it is -1. So I gave you these rules. So you have to memorize these rules. There's nothing else. How do I know these rules? Because I have a lot of interest in chemistry. I try to ask that question. Why is it that no book will tell me? I try to ask myself that question. Why is it that oxygen has -2? So then I realize that oxygen has totally 8 electrons, 2 in the first shell, 6 in the second. Oxygen has absolutely no tendency to give. It will take both those 2 electrons wherever it is. Now, because oxygen is going to take 2 electrons, oxygen is in a -2 state. Yeah. Then, not a part of this chapter again, out of my own interest I learned, why is O2 2-? Then? Because here 2 O's are bonded together. Now, if 2 same species are bonded together, neither of them can pull the electron. So, the charge will not be there with anyone. Now, with whomever this hydrogen is, this oxygen is bonded, and whomever this oxygen is bonded, now it will pull the electron. So, this will have a -1, this will have a -1. So, total is -2. So, O2 is -2. Okay. So, this I have learned out of my own interest. Over years, by reading books. But you guys don't have to read books, because you have Google power. So ask questions and ask Google power. Google will tell you answers for everything. Okay, so coming back, Cr2O7 2-. So now, because there are 7 oxygens. Okay, first, what do you mean by Cr2O7? Cr2O7 means there are 7 oxygens and there are 2 chromiums. 2- means the net charge of it is 2. So now, because there are 7 oxygens, there should be 7 × 2, 14 negative charge. Now, out of 14 negative charge, net charge is 2. That means what? There must have been 12 positive charge. So now those 12 positive charge are coming from 2 chromium. So each chromium will be how much? Each chromium will be +6. So this is how you find out the oxidation state of any species or oxidation number of any species. Okay. So here is a species given to you. Suppose I have KMnO4. So potassium is +1. Always potassium is +1. Manganese, I don't know. Oxygen, I know. Is each one is -2, so 4 are there. So -8. So manganese should be +7. Why? Because this is a compound. There is no charge given on it. So it is neutral. So total positive must be equal to total negative. So now manganese is +7. So this is how I find out. How do I know potassium is +1? I memorized it. Okay. Yeah, I will show. So did you understand? Yeah, they'll come. How many have come so far? Let me see. 100 have come. Okay, please call up your friends. I'm going to start only later, or maybe today we'll just do some doubt clarification, and only tomorrow's class we'll be able to do it once everybody knows how to reach here. I'll just make a call to our coordinator and find out. Huh? Solitary king la enna? I'm not able to understand. The old link, what is the problem with the old link? But Vishnu, you have to do something. You can't just sit there. Only 100 people have come out of 170. So please call up each one of them who has not come and then please do it. There is nothing else that you can do. So please don't sit there saying that I can't do anything right now. Please do something about it and get me the attendance for all the other classes also. People are not able to log in. Yeah, even now they are telling me, sir, many people are finding it difficult to log in. So please do something. Please be in action. Don't tell me that I'm waiting for something to happen. Please. Yeah. Yes, hereafter we have to log in only like this. When we were giving the login IDs, that was getting misplaced. There were some outsiders who were coming into our class and they are disturbing our class. So today, one day we will have some problem, but in the long run, this will solve all our other problems. Okay. No problem. Today, there is nothing. Today, I'm only going to clear doubts. So whatever doubts you have, you please ask. So whatever doubts you have, please. Definition for oxidation state. It is the charge. It is the apparent charge on an atom in a compound. Oxidation state is the apparent charge on an element in its compounds or in any compound. Yes, oxidation state is synonymous to oxidation number. We don't want it. We don't need it. It is not there in our syllabus. You don't need to find out oxidation structure, oxidation a number or state through structure of a compound. Not required in NCERT syllabus. Apparent means it's not reality, but we can say it has it. Okay, so I'll just show you the slides first so that then we can come back. So here the first question, people were asking me what kind of books to read. The problem of reading any of these books is that they have content outside NCERT. Okay, so we will be learning things which are very difficult, but we will not be mastered the simple things. So please focus only on the NCERT book. Whenever you are reading, this is very simple. Now, if I have to show off that I have great knowledge, now I will try to draw you all kinds of structures and tell you that, you know, how oxidation state and structures are related. But that is something that you don't need it. So we learn the simple things perfectly. That is my simple concept in life. Learn simple things perfectly. Okay, so if we do this, it is more than enough. There are a lot of other things that we can learn. We don't have to learn. Okay, if you stick to NCERT syllabus, it is more than enough. And even if you are reading other books, we may ask you questions in the exam. Don't worry about it. We don't set the exam papers. As a teacher, I want to show you that I know a lot. Okay. So I will definitely teach you more than what is there in more than NCERT, only to keep you in attention. That is when you will say, sir, nalla soli kuduthirukanga, NCERT la irukadha solranga, adhuk malayum solranga. Adhu mattum kadaiyadhu. Every teacher knows. And they don't want to relearn. The nature of the NEET exam and your NCERT board exams have changed in the past 2 years. Okay, so if I know a lot of things, I don't want to relearn, saying that what has to be learned, what doesn't have to be learned. So that is the problem. Okay, so please focus on what is needed. That is more than enough. Yeah. So I was explaining to you, what do you mean by apparent? So this is the meaning of apparent. Really, there is no charge of -1 on chlorine. It is just an assumption. Why are we assuming? Because chlorine is more electronegative. And why is chlorine more electronegative? We will learn all that things later. So we have a lot of time. we will learn. Everything cannot be learnt in one go. Okay, so we will learn again about redox reactions. We will learn again after we learn little bit more chemistry. So once we learn little bit more chemistry and go, then we will know it better. Okay, so let me just see. So many, sir. What type of balance redox reaction first by one by the ions, and what is 2 and 3? See, you can do it by partial equations method that I did. Second one, you can do it by oxidation number method. Third thing is you can do by ions. So we have done all these three. We have done. But you don't need all these three. If you know how to do it by oxidation number method and ions, it is more than enough. How to identify whether a reaction is oxidation or reduction when it comes to electrons? Oxidation is a losing electrons. Reduction is a taking electrons. Reduction means to reduce. But the opposite of that is to take. So remember that way. In my opinion, you work out this, it is more than enough. Okay, this is very good for numericals, but the numericals may be outside your syllabus. Yeah, that is very good for numericals, but the numericals may be outside your syllabus. This was slide 1. This was slide 2. This is slide 3. So I'll take few more examples and I can explain. So suppose you have H2C2O4. The question is, what is the oxidation state on carbon? So 4 oxygens, each oxygen is -2. So total is -8. Here total is +2. So carbon should be +6, 2 carbons +6. So each carbon will be +3. Now this becomes CO2. So H2C2O4 becomes CO2. Yeah, here it is in +3 state. Here it is in +4 state. So how can something move from +3 to +4? By giving electrons. Yeah, so here carbon has given electron. So if it has given electron, means it has lost electron. So if it has lost electron, means it is oxidation. Okay, lost electron means oxidation. Gained electron means reduction. Similarly, suppose Fe2+ has become Fe3+. How can Fe2+ become Fe3+? By losing electron. Yeah, so this is also oxidation. Hmm. 1 minute. Okay, good. Almost reached the good strength. Yeah, please write the definition in the screen. What definition? Okay, I will write oxidation. She's still bent on. Oxidation means loss of electrons. Yes, reduction means gain in electrons. How to identify, I explain to you. Species is anything which has existence. Sir, what type of balanced reactions? Okay, I explain to you. Sir, write the definition of oxidation state on the screen. I will write. But the sum is confusing. Fe2SO3SO43. Okay. So, oxidation state. Is the apparent charge on an element in its compounds. It is determined by following some rules. So oxidation state or number is the apparent charge on an element in its compound or ion. It is determined by following certain rules. That rules I told you in the last class. I explained to you, there is no difference between oxidation state and oxidation number. Oxidation state and oxidation number are the same. There is a difference between valency and oxidation number and state. Valency refers to the number of electrons gained or shared between by an element in its compound. But oxidation refers to the apparent charge on it. So if you see oxygen, so it has shared two electrons. So what is the valency of oxygen? 2. Why? Because each oxygen has shared two electrons with the other oxygen. What is the oxidation state of oxygen here? Oxidation state of oxygen is 0. Why is it 0? Because both of them are oxygen, so neither can pull. So there is no charge on this and there is no charge on this. Yeah. So the oxidation number or oxidation state refers to the charge on the element. Okay. But valency refers to the number of electrons actually shared or lost by a element. For all metals belonging to group the S block, that is a group 1. So we don't know. We will learn slowly only. We will learn. All your questions can't be answered on one day because we have just begun our learning and they are all interrelated. So suppose you have S block elements. So S block elements, valency and oxidation number is the same. So potassium has a valency 1. Its oxidation state is also 1. Sodium has a valency 1. Its oxidation state is also 1. Magnesium has a valency 2. Its oxidation state is also 2. Calcium has a valency 2. Its oxidation state is also 2. So for certain elements, oxidation state and valency are the same. For certain metals, let's say manganese, Mn, it is not the same. Mn, valency is plus 2, but its oxidation state can be plus 2, can be plus 6, can be plus 7, can be plus 4. Valency is 1, but oxidation state can be many. Because this is a apparent charge. It is not a real charge. It's the apparent charge. Okay, so that is the difference between valency and oxidation number. I saw a lecture given by Wayne Brisley. He taught that elements belonging to group 17 will have minus 1 as their oxidation number. Not true. Elements belonging to group 17. So I'll tell you a few elements belonging to group 17. So group 17, chlorine is an example of group 17. So chlorine, HCl has minus 1. This is plus 1. NaCl, this is minus 1, plus 1. MgCl2, this is minus 1, this is plus 2. Okay, but 2 are there, so it will take care. Yeah, but whenever chlorine is with oxygen, it is not minus. So chlorine, because chlorine is more electronegative than, because oxygen is more electronegative than chlorine, it will pull. So you have a compound HClO. HClO, oxygen is minus 2. Hydrogen is plus 1. So the chlorine here is plus 1. Then you have HClO2. Here oxygen is minus 2. 2 oxygens will become minus 4. This is plus 1. Chlorine will become plus 3. Okay. So you have plus 1, plus 3. Then chlorine will become HClO3. This is plus 5. Then you have HClO4. Then this is plus 7. Now, chlorine has a structure of 2, 8, 7. So if it is like this, that means chlorine has given away all its electrons. So after that, can it give any more electrons? It cannot. That is why HClO5 cannot exist. I had asked you this question in one of the assignment questions. We have HClO, we have HClO2, HClO3, HClO4, but why do we not have HClO5? Because now in HClO4 itself, chlorine has given away all its outermost shell electrons. Yeah, so if it has given away all its outermost shell electrons, then it can't give any more. So you don't have HClO5. Okay, so here the valency of chlorine, the number of this is it. So the oxidation state is +7. So it is wrong that group 17 elements can go only to -1. They can take. Yeah, I will show you. Don't worry. Yeah, so again, what I'm trying to say is that there are a lot of things on the internet. There are basically, please understand that science is vast. Okay, so now the moment we start asking questions, we will have a lot of questions in our mind. Now we need to know how to answer them, and you have to it takes years to answer. It doesn't happen that, you know, one button and then you have answered all your questions. It can never happen. So only over a period of time it will, but you have to keep your questions ready. And when you are reading, you have to see how the different questions that you are asking are being answered. Okay, so this is the fifth slide. This is the sixth one. I was telling you about the different. Wanted to know the oxidation definition. Here is the oxidation state definition. Yeah, so let me see if there are any more questions which have come up. So tell us a simple way to memorize. No, you can't memorize a periodic table. You don't have to memorize. You have to know the periodic table, and you don't need to know the full thing. If you know up to 40, it is enough. So we have to learn how to draw the structure of some compounds, or we have to mug up the structure for finding the oxidation number. First thing is, you don't have to learn to draw the structure of compounds right now. You have not been taught that. It comes in later chapters. When it comes, we will learn it at that time. Okay, show the definition slide. I'll show again. Yeah, what is the difference? Okay, so good. So let us go back. Up to atomic number 40, you have to mug up. Okay, yeah, so fine. So a little bit of teaching I can still do now. So let me do some more little bit of teaching I can do. Okay, so I hope you have understood this. I hope you have understood this. Definition slide, somebody wanted. Here is the definition slide. I still see many of you all have not submitted your assignments. Okay, actually very few have submitted the assignments. So this is not the right thing. I think today onwards I have to start calling you guys up and then telling you, asking you, where is your assignment? Also, some of us are not writing the weekend tests. That's also bad. We don't look for 100 score in that. Look for learning. The ability to learn is the most important thing that you could have. Okay, so here. Yeah. So if it is all done, we move on. Like I said, today we won't be learning much, but the next class onwards, we will be learning. New student should be going. There's a new batch. You should be joining the new batch. There's a new batch. You call me up later. I will tell you. Yes, weekend tests will be tough. That is why we have to know. We have to know that there is a difference between what we are learning and what we are expected to learn. So slowly over a period of time, things will get better. If you are not able to send your assignment through Learnity, please message. Please send it by message to me. This is my number. Okay, so this is my number. So I will answer your queries. Please send your queries here. Okay, so this is my WhatsApp number. You can send your assignments, but try to send it on Learnity. It will be possible. Okay, so I hope we have learnt. I want you guys to do me a few things. I want you to write this down here. I am telling you, I'm giving you a list of some anions. And I'm going to give you a list of some cations. Okay. Now, all of us should try to do this. Yeah. List of anions. See, anions have charge on them. So I'm giving you those which have a charge 1. Yeah. Anions are negatively charged species. Okay. Anions are negatively charged species. Cations are positively charged species. Okay. This you have to mug it up. Cations are positively charged species. Anions are negatively charged species. So if you are having negatively charged species, there could be species which have charge 1. So names of species which have charge 1. So you have chlorine minus. Chlorine minus is called CHLORIDE. Chloride. The name for it is chloride. Okay. Then you have Br minus. Bromide. BROMIDE. Then you have I minus. So I minus is iodide. Okay. Then you have NO3 minus. This is nitrate. Okay, because it is O3, it is nitrate. Then you have NO2 minus. This is nitrite. Yeah, NO2, O2. Lesser oxygen will take ITE. More oxygen will take ATE. Okay, then you have COOH minus. This is formate. COO minus, formate. Yeah. So these are some anions which have charge 1. So you may make a list of this. There are more are there. HCO3 minus, bicarbonate. CO32 minus is carbonate. HCO3 minus is bicarbonate. Whenever H comes, it becomes bi. So HSO3, bisulfite. HSO4, bisulfate. HS minus. Bisulfide. So this is how they are named. We have to remember these names. Yeah, I will be your teacher. You said that if color in crackers is red, it will be calcium, not magnesium. Magnesium will be white. Is it possible to have multiple color? Yes. With the same cation, multiple color is not possible. Sir, in periodic table, till 40 is enough. That means they will not ask from rest of them. No, they will not ask from rest of them. Sir, I see my Learnity account. My homework is not visible today. How can I find it whether it is sent or not? Uh-huh. Harshini, I will check. Sir, I came late. Can I know what you taught till now? Nothing. I'm waiting for people. I know that today people are having difficulty in logging in. So I'm just talking about XYZ. So they're asking me, why you want CDR sir to come? I don't know when he will come. Yes, Prajesh, tell me if you have any difficulties with me, you tell me. I will show you ion slide. ओके या ओके सो हियर इज द आयन स्लाइड. Okay, there are more. I will tell you more. So today we are just going to learn some simple things. I'll give you some homework. So actually, that is the biggest problem, is that I give a lot of homework. Okay, please write these. So these are all ions, negative ions, which have charge 1. Because they are negative ions, they are called anions. Bisulfide, bicarbonate, bisulfite, lesser oxygen, sulfite. Larger, more oxygen, 8. O3 nitrate, lesser oxygen, nitrite. Okay, so these are all cations which have charge 1. Please make a note of them. Sorry, these are all anions which have charge 1. Okay, then I will write down some anions which have charge 2. Carbonate, CO3 2-. Carbonate, CO3 2- is carbonate. Then SO4 2- is sulfate. SO3 2- is sulfite. Then S2- is sulfide. S2- is sulfide. C2O4 2- is oxalate. So these are all species which have charge 2. Okay. So these are all ions, anions which have charge 2. Then I have anions which have charge 3. Okay. So PO4 3-. This is phosphate. Okay, so we will remember these. Yeah. Now I will give you list of cations. Charge 1. You have sodium. Na+. You have K+, potassium. Then you have lithium+. This is lithium. Then you have ammonium, NH4+. Ammonium. So you have sodium, potassium, lithium, ammonium. Okay, so these are all cations, positively charged species, which have a charged 1, which have charge 1. You want some more species which have charge 3 here. N3- is nitride. Okay. Then cation which have charge 2. Cations which have charge 2. Ca2+. Mg2+. Zinc2+. Iron2+. Copper2+. Manganese, Mn2+. Then you have tin, 2 plus. Then species which have a charge, 3. Species which have charge 3. Aluminium, 3 plus. Many are there. I am only telling you those which we need. Fe 3 plus. So this is ferrous. This is ferrous. F-E-R-R-O-U-S. Ferrous. This is ferric. F-E-R-R-I-C. Ferric. Ferrous. Ferric. This is cupric. That means plus 2 is cupric, means there will be a Cu plus 1. Cu plus 1 is cuprous, C-U-P-R-O-U-S, cuprous. Okay, cuprous, cupric. So these are all some species which have charge 3. I want to give you one homework. The homework is write names of compounds. A compound is formed by the combination of a cation and an anion. So suppose the cation that you have chosen is ammonium and the anion that you have chosen is sulfate. So the compound formed will be the compound. This is one species, this is one species. But this has a charge 2 minus, okay? This has a charge 2 minus, this has a charge plus 1. So, by you exchange the charges, so you need two of them. If you get two of them, then the charge will be balanced. So, it is NH4 twice SO4. Okay, here SO4 is one species. NH4, ammonium, is another species. Ammonium exists together as a group. SO4 exists together as a group. So, I never break SO4. I never break ammonium. Okay. And the name of this compound is ammonium, A-M-M-O-N-I-U-M, ammonium sulfate. The name of this compound is ammonium sulfate. Okay. So, what I want you to do is I want you to please show previous slides. I will. NaCl, cuprous, yes. Then what is copper? Copper is an element. Charged copper has a different name. So can you please send us the Seekers redox reaction chapter in Lanity? Yeah, I will send. Yeah, what is the difference between copper, cuprous, cupric? Copper is uncharged. So you go buy a copper wire. Cuprous, if it has a charge, plus 1. Cupric, if it has a charge, plus 2. Okay, so here is the ninth slide, anions. Make a list. Today we are not learning much. Next class, tomorrow's class, we will be learning atomic structure. We have done enough of this. I'll organize a few classes wherein I'll discuss problems on mole concept and basic concepts in chemistry. Okay, now the learning of redox is good. What we have learned, we even don't have that much in our syllabus. So please don't worry about it. You will do well and we are going to revisit it again. Yeah, so these are some anions. So these are anions which have charge 1. These have anions which have charge 2. These are some anions which have charge 3. We can keep adding. You want me to add more? We can add more. Cn minus is cyanide. Extremely poisonous. Extremely poisonous. Cyanide is very, very, very poisonous. Then these are anions which have charge 3. after some anions which have charged 3, I have written some cations which have charged 1, 2, and 3. And the homework is write compounds using these anions and cations. Write compounds using these anions and cations. Okay, many are there, numerous are there. I have not written Ag plus. Titanium is there. 4 charge 4 is also there. Sn. Sn plus 4 is there. Charge 4. Nickel is also there with plus 4. Plus 4 and plus 2. Both are there. Okay. So I want you to combine these anions and cations and write the names of the compounds. Sn is tin. You can write with each totally there are, wait, first. So this is the anion slide. Totally, let's count how many anions are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 anions are there here. 17, 18 anions are totally given. So 18 anions are there. That is, we have written as of now. So this is the slide with the anions. This is the slide with the cations. Cations, we have written 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 16 cations we have. So somebody can tell me how many compounds you can write. So this is the slide on anions. We have 18 anions and we have written 16 cations. So totally, how many compounds can you write? So the way I'm expecting you to do is Ag, cation, and then you take another one. You take, let's say, cyanide, Cn minus. So the name of the compound is AgCn. Sorry, the AgCn is the compound. The name of the compound is silver cyanide. Okay. Then again, we have not written MnO4. We can write MnO4 minus also. So we can make it both the numbers to be the same. Oh, this side we have written more. Okay, fine, no problem. So here you can write MnO4 minus. Here you can write Cr2O7 2 minus. Okay, so this is called the permanganate. Permanganate. This is called dichromate. Okay. So you can write names. You can write as many names as you want to, but you write at least the 2-3 with each anion. At least you write. Yeah. Okay. So then the last topic in balancing equations was always there. Balancing equations in both acidic medium and basic medium is there. Yes, 288 compounds you can write. 20 compounds is too less. Cation is limiting reagent. No. Limiting reagent na enna? Limiting na adu kammiya irukku. Oh, andha maadhiri solringla. Cation kammiya irukka. Illa cationu nariya eludalam. Net for some names. I won't like it. I would like, see, one big mistake all of us make, Harish, is we always want everything to be right. Please understand, the only way to learn is to make mistakes. So the way I would expect it is, first you write down the names the way you think it is. Don't worry about it. There won't be any red marks. I'll never put a red mark. We'll cover, correct them only with blue ink. Okay. Then what we will do is, then we will check the internet and then see what we have done is right or wrong. Okay. Cn is not a gas. Cyanide Cn minus. Cn minus is a species. It's an ion. Santosh, what is your question? Your question vanishes, pa. Enge irke? Santosh. NH4, SO4, the charge is not balanced. So you write it NH4. No, what do you mean charge is not balanced? Charge is balanced. NH4, okay. See, that is where we will learn. As you guys see, you have NH4 plus 1, SO4 2 minus. Okay, so this is plus 1, this is 2 minus. So the charge is not balanced. So how do I balance the charge? By taking two of these. So I'll take two of these and then I'll take one of these. Now you see the charge is balanced. Similarly, suppose you have aluminium plus 3. And suppose you have NO3 minus nitrate. Okay. So now here plus 3, but minus is only 1. So what will you do? So you will take aluminium, nitrate, 3. So now charge is also balanced. Another example I'll give. Suppose you have Fe plus 3, ferric. And you have the sulfate 2 minus. Now how will you balance? So it's tough to balance. So you take two of these and then you take three of these so that it will become plus 6 plus 6. So the name of the compound is Se2FO4SO4 thrice, and it is called a ferric, FerricSulfate, ferric sulfate. Purida? Ferrous sulfate. Ferrous na inge plus 2 irukku, inge plus 2 irukku. Appa charge same aada irukku. Appa onnonna edutha 10. So FeSO4 ferrous sulfate. Okay. Idu ferrous sulfate, idu ferric sulfate. Okay. Nama enna pandrom edhaadu compound endradhukku apparam and the charge balance pandrom, plus minus balance pandrom. Okay. Yeah, cross multiply. Okay, sir, can we write only the name of the compound? You can write only the name of the compound. Okay, you can write only the name of the compound. You don't have to write every steps. You don't have to write. Don't waste paper. Cyanide is present in the seeds of apple. We've seen that in some movie, but I doubt it. Yes, redox reactions and electrode processes is there. But we don't know enough of it as of now. Okay, so we will learn it a little later. Any other compound? Oh, we have not seen compounds of arsenic. Arsenic is deadly poisonous. Even like 1 milligram is, we have not seen arsenic at all. Arsenic is very, very poisonous. Lot of them are dangerous. I won't say poisonous, but dangerous. Gallium is very dangerous. Then we don't talk about, that's why we don't talk about all of them. Okay, in the oxidation assignment, Na2S4O6 oxidation number of sulfur. But yeah, that is another difference between valency and oxidation number. While valency is always an integer, valency is the number of electrons given or taken. You can give one electron or take one electron. You can give two electrons or take two electrons. So valency is always an integer. Always an integer. Okay, but when you are finding out oxidation number, you are finding the average oxidation number. Okay, you are finding out the average oxidation number. So when you are finding out the average, it can be a fraction. We have seen in the case of Na2S4O6. Yeah, here the fraction indicates that there are multiple sulfur-sulfur bonds. There are multiple sulfur-sulfur bonds. So whenever there are multiple sulfur-sulfur bonds, neither of them can take the electron. See, if two people are equally strong and they are pulling a cloth, who will get the cloth? Nobody will get the cloth. Maybe the cloth will tear in the middle because they both are equally strong. But if one person is strong, another person is weak, the stronger person will pull it. Right? So the half-half indicates that there are multiple SS bonds. And the most important thing is we are finding out the average oxidation number. That means in a compound, the same element may have may have different oxidation states. Different oxidation states. Okay, so in the same compound, the same element may have different oxidation states. So that when you are finding out the average, 2.5 is coming. Okay. Yeah, upcoming test is redox. Redox, what is the oxidation state of nitrogen in NOCl? So you have NOCl. Okay, NOCl. Now here you have to understand that. So just 1 minute. There's a call coming because, okay, next class I will explain this, okay? Let me just show you the slides and then let me just move. Next class I will explain. The first one, second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one, then sixth one, seventh one, ninth one, eighth one is nothing is there, my number only is there, ninth one, tenth one, 11th one. So I didn't teach anything today. Next class I will do. Okay, we will do atomic structure. You asked me for the oxidation number of nitrogen in NOCl. See here, NOCl, no, this OCl is one group. So O is always minus 2. And O, chlorine with O is here plus 1. So this is how much? This is minus 1. So if this is minus 1, what will happen to nitrogen? Nitrogen will be in the plus 1. So the oxidation state of this is plus 1. See, this is a tough question. This is a tough question. You will learn this only when you read. Later on, you will be reading nitrogen and its compounds. Okay, so when we read nitrogen and its compounds, then we will get to know about these. We will read about all the elements individually, we will read. So there is so much more. We've just started our journey. So please don't get worried. Just keep these questions with you. That is what is more important. And look for solutions, definitely. Okay, so this is 13th. This is 14th. Then 15th. Okay, so I will see you again, hopefully tomorrow onwards. Please show slide number 1, 4 and 10. Here is 1. These are, somebody asked me what books to read. These are 4. Somebody asked me, should I read much? I told no, read only NCERT perfectly. Learn simple things perfectly. In your questions, only KMnO4 will come. Only K2Cr2O7 will come. So if you know these two perfectly, you are done. 90% is done. Now, I can give you 20 other compounds and we may say that it is all very difficult. But only this will come in your exam. So why are you even bothered about this? See, your examination has 720 marks. Out of 720 marks, we want to target 600. Out of 600, that means we have to get 150 questions correct. Yeah, in biology, you have 90 questions. In physics, you have 45 questions. In chemistry, you have 45 questions. Now here, I will be happy. Actually, I will be happy if you get 30, more than 30 correct. But let us aim for 35. Let us aim for 35. Here, let us aim for 80. So biology is easy. I will learn perfectly. Physics, chemistry, there will, I will learn. I will learn well. but I may not be able to answer all of them. Even then, I get 280 marks here. Even then, I get 300 plus here. So together, I can get 600. Okay, so please understand that the mistake that everybody makes is they want to learn so much. And when they learn so much, they are making mistakes. You learn this much perfectly, more than enough to get a good score. Okay, 4. Then you wanted 10. Here is 10. Okay, so I'll stop here. Bye-bye. See you again. Yeah, they will give minus marks. We will see. Okay, bye.